what was your take of the President's State of the Union address, and did you think that he was more conciliatory or took a harder stance when it came to the border wall? You know, it's funny, when you read the headlines in the morning the day after, it's sort of like a Rorschach test in terms of what people take away from what was actually said.
Well, I think the president went to his core principles, his core values of national security, homeland security. In terms of the wall, as chairman of the subcommittee of homeland security, I thought he sort of stated the obvious, that he has been consistent in his beliefs, and that is that we need a comprehensive border security plan that includes a barrier and a wall. And I think there should have been no surprise of anybody in the audience that the president reinforced that. But I think it's important, at least from my standpoint, being on the conference committee, that the president sort of charged us, get together, compromise, look for a bill that kind of meets all these standards. And so I think he threw it back in our court, which, quite frankly, I'm grateful to. And I think if those of us on the conference committee are optimistic that we can meet that challenge.
So you really do feel charged with the ability now to find a compromise when it comes to this very contentious issue of the border wall.
Well, absolutely. And the people in the room are seasoned appropriators like myself who do this every year. We try to strike a balance between our different interests and our different priorities, and we find something in the middle. And that's what we're getting back to work at it early this morning.
Senator Bayh?
Yeah, Shelley, welcome. Hi. And I did notice that my good friend and your colleague, Joe Manchin, was standing and applauding last night more than many of the other Democrats. So if we could just have the West Virginians work this out, I too would be optimistic. So we obviously all hope that we can get a deal done here. The seeds of a deal should be there because there have been agreements on this sort of thing in the past.
Right.
So why did the president characterize the efforts of the committee as a waste of time last week? Why is he more pessimistic than you are?
Well, you know, that was disheartening, quite frankly, that the president kind of prejudged where we were going as a waste of time. I think as time has gone on, I think he's seen the commitment from both the Democrats and the Republicans on the committee in the public statements, but also the ability. He knows that we're negotiating back and forth. Nobody's shut down here, to use that term. And so we're working together. And I think hopefully he'll sort of adopt the stance that he did last night. This is now in your court. Members of Congress come up with a compromise.
Hopefully they'll stay off Twitter because things right. seem to be going well, and then something aggravates them and a tweet comes over the transom and makes it more difficult. Well, good luck to you.
Thanks,
I hope that
Evan.
He will leave it to the conference committee, and hopefully we get a deal done.
Well, I think, Senator, you bring up a great point here, which is that we have the teleprompter Trump, as we might say, right, in conciliatory tone, and then we're just kind of waiting for that next tweet.
Like in the next, like now.
Like perhaps at any moment, we're sort of on tenterhooks here, waiting for that. Do you think there's anybody, and it's a serious point, do you think there's anybody that can get to him and say, listen, you've come off this speech, there were some great moments, all right? We had some applause on both sides. We had some cheers, the moment where he talked about the number of women legislators. Everyone stood up, chants of USA. How can you get to him and say, you have goodwill? Don't blow it.
Well, that's
I'll go to Bayh, and then Senator, I want to hear from you as well.
Great, Shelley. Well, look, there have been people around him a long time, including his own family members, who've been urging him to stick to the script and try and be a little more on message. And it just doesn't work. This president just doesn't seem to function that way. I suspect we won't see any tweets today because the response to the speech was pretty good. He's probably feeling, you know, pretty happy about things. I would look to Friday morning before Michael Cohen's testimony in the House. He may be a little more aggravated then, right? So it's just part of his DNA. He just doesn't seem to be able to help himself.
Well, and, you know, the way I look at it, too, you know, I always try to spin something positively because I'm an optimistic person and positive person. We know how the president feels. He's pretty honest in these tweets. And while they aggravate and we're all on pins and needles sometimes here on Capitol Hill to see is there something coming up next unexpected, at the same time, I think we know where he stands. So in terms of the committee, I really think the best thing that the president can do is let us work our will. And so I'm hoping he stays silent on that at least for the next several days.
Senator Capito, you sound pretty optimistic about the makings of some kind of a deal with this committee. You say you're going back and forth with offers. Is it basically just trading numbers right now? I mean, characterize, I guess, the nature of these negotiations and maybe your confidence level that something comes out of it.
Well, I think, you know, I'm cautiously optimistic, but I'm also realistic and realize that this could be very difficult. Neither the Speaker nor the President has given a number certain that if it goes over or under, it's a no deal. I think that is good. And I was glad the president didn't get into specifics last night. But there's obviously a strong disagreement there. Let's try, you know, I'm speaking with my Democrat counterparts in the House and the Senate. I think we, you know, after the shutdown, I think we all sort of feel like here in Congress that we need to prove the American people that we can do what they sent us here to do, which is to reach a compromise. Senator Bayh did it all the time in his service here. We should be able to get there, and we're familiar with the people on the committee.
What's the probability, Senator Capito, of another shutdown in 10 days? I mean, you're an optimistic person, but you did say that you're cautiously optimistic on how things are going in the committee level.
Well, I think I don't think we'll have another shutdown.
You don't.
I think it was a misery path, and the most misery path. So I don't feel we'll go that direction. I think the bigger question will be if we reach a compromise, how the president interprets that compromise.